Happening now, the inaugural edition of a holiday basketball tournament in honor of George Floyd. Minneapolis North and the Houston Yates are facing off on the court right now before game two, which happens at 7:30. Now, the tournament's being held on the same campus that hosted Floyd's funeral back in 2020. And as John Croman reports, the connections to the tournament's namesake don't end there.
I wanted to celebrate the positives of George Floyd.
North High coach Larry McKenzie came up with the idea of a holiday invitational tournament honoring the man whose death sparked a new era of racial reckoning in this nation.
But the young star athlete, right, that navigated an urban community in Houston, in spite of many challenges that may have been in his life, that was still able to graduate from high school, that got a Division I scholarship to go on to play basketball.
One of the visiting teams, Houston's Jack Yates High, is where Floyd played football in his youth. Yates basketball coach Eddie Barlow knew Floyd and his family.
I was younger than him, but he was one of the ones that we looked up to as far as athletic-wise, and he was always supportive of the young guys.
Another connection, one of North High's coaches served on the jury that convicted Derek Chauvin of murder.
Brandon Mitchell was one of the jurors.
And he's one of the coaches.
And he's my JV coach, my head JV coach. The name of George Floyd will be with us for the rest of my life and the rest of the young people that are listening to life. He will always be in the history books.
We represent George Floyd, right? Because we are George Floyd. They are George Floyd. They walk the same hallways that George walked. They are living in the same projects that George grew up from. And that could have been any of us.
The Houston coach, Eddie Barlow, says he plans to bring his team down to George Floyd Square before they leave town on Thursday. It'll be an emotional moment for him because it's the first time he's been in the Twin Cities since this all happened. In Minneapolis, John Croman, KIR 11 News.